Wes and I, on our first day, I have never been so drunk in my life, and it was the funniest day I've ever been on. Literally, yeah. We had the whole restaurant in fits of laughter. I think I was like rolling on the floor at one point. Hi, I'm Arabella.
And I'm Michael.
And we're here with Grazia.
And we're going to be telling you our dating deal breakers.
I turn up late. I mean, I'm always late, so it's definitely not a deal breaker.
It can't be a deal breaker because I'm always late.
When is too late?
Half an hour.
Really? I mean...
Well, yeah, because imagine sitting in a restaurant. Okay, this is if it's a restaurant.
45 minutes to an hour. Oh,
I mean, if I was waiting for an hour for someone, I'd be like, well, I've already ordered my food, so see you later.
See, I'd be like, yeah, you definitely owe me, so I'm definitely getting some.
Love a Nando's.
Winner, chicken dinner.
I mean, love one's not everything, yeah.
It's not a deal breaker, though. I mean, it just means it frees up some time at night.
Yeah. I'd be a bit like, are you just a freaky fan?
Yeah.
I think then you go into like the fan zone.
Yeah, it's like you're not really, you're a fangirl.
Or a fan guy.
Would you feel comfortable telling them to shut up?
100%.
Yeah.
100%. I'm not really bothered, I'll tell someone to shut up.
See, I have only ever dated Pisces in my life. So, I mean, I've got exes for a reason, but Wes is a Pisces. Wes and I actually have, but our birthdays are a day apart.
Are you a Pisces?
Yeah. I'm a Pisces.
That doesn't really bother me. Like star signs.
Are you into them?
I'm not really that bothered.
I'm really into star signs. I'm quite spiritual, so I feel like that's what it... Yeah, I feel like I believe in star signs. Because I feel like all my exes, even though they're exes for a reason, have got like similar characteristics. I find that hilarious.
Yeah, I'm going to get on that same level.
Wes and I, on our first day, I have never been so drunk in my life. And it was the funniest day I've ever been on. Literally, yeah. We had the whole restaurant in fits of laughter. I think I was like rolling on the floor at one point.
It just makes the date more exciting.
Yeah.
Ooh.
See, I'm not a massive, massive drinker, but I do love to have a drink and I do love to have, like, let my hair down and have a good time, but I'm not like every single night I need a glass of wine. So I think that I would find an issue if they never drank, ever.
I like to get messy sometimes and just get to the point where someone's gonna carry me home and I will tell them that.
Yeah, I think it would be an issue, in all honesty.
Yeah.
I mean, I've literally done every single diet under the sun. I've tried everything. So I'd probably just be like, oh, it's a new phase. I'm just gonna try whatever diet you wanna try.
Yeah, it doesn't really bother me either. Like, I've kind of cut down on my meat intake, so it doesn't really bother me. Oh no, like, I'm paying the bill.
I'll always offer, but I do find that guys tend to be quite persistent to pick up the bill.
I mean, I won't even let you see the bill, I'll just pay it.
I find this weird.
It's a bit weird.
I just don't understand. I've got quite a few exes, and I'm like, you can be civil, but if you were like chummy with them, like, how are you friends with someone that, like, unless the only way I could think it's okay is if like you were like childhood sweethearts and like you kind of grew up together and you had a relationship from like a young age, and then, but not someone that's like just split up with just before you have a relationship with them, then I find that's quite strange.
Like, if it's a proper relationship, then it's a bit weird. Like, if you've been together for like a year or 2 years or whatever, and then you've broken up over something, whatever. If you're then best friends with them, it's a little bit weird.
Yeah, like, I feel that's why I feel like childhood sweethearts, like, you were kind of friends first.
Yeah. Like, there's definitely unfinished business there if you're still and you're definitely still sleeping together. I don't like it.
No, I don't like it.
I've been a waiter, so I can't stand people who are rude to hospitality staff. That's fine.
It's fine. There's like everyone's got their own reasons. Like, you don't have to have your own place. Like, yeah.
Having your own place is just one of those things that's a nice to have. But
yeah, it's a luxury.
It seems like nowadays more people are living with their parents.
And also, if my parents lived in London, I would live with my parents. I'd be like, I'm going to stay with you and have that Sunday roast.
I mean, my mum and dad didn't ever want me to move out. Like, even when I was like, yeah, I'm moving out, they're like, you don't need to, you know, like, you're only going to be like 20.
I moved out when I was 11. I was like, get me out.
I moved out when I was 16. Yeah. But then I moved back home when I went to uni. And my mum was so happy to see me back. She's like, tell me anything you need. I'll make sure we get it. And I was like, I'll go buy it.
I'm Arabella.
And I'm Michael.
And they were our dating deal breakers.